Hi friends, welcome to Sri Chaitanya. This is Uma Shankar. And this is JEE Main Sure Daily Series, Season 2. So far we have completed Season 1 and this is Season 2. Especially in Season 2, in our JEE Main Sure Daily Series, we are concentrating the tips, shortcuts and tests of most important topics which are coming for JEE Mains examination. And of course, these tips and tricks, they are forever useful for all the competitive examinations, even for board examinations also. My friends, this is JEE Main Sure Daily Series Season 2, Series Number 4. And please, again, I am repeating, please don't forget to check the description, because along this season, what we are doing is we are providing some of the important tips and tricks or shortcuts of the questions along with some suitable formulae. And of that, simultaneously, along this video, we are providing some tests. The test may be either in the form of a part test or full test or grand test or a topic wise test also. So that's why, once after watching the video very carefully, noting down the all the recommended formulae, please don't forget to check the description and don't forget to share and subscribe this channel. Okay. Now, my friends, today's topic is again a indefinite integrations, because in indefinite integration, this is third one. Here, now today we are concentrating five concepts and five problems. And of course, along this video, I am providing one full test. Full test means on entire JEE Mains syllabus, new pattern JEE Mains Maths, Physics and Chemistry, a full test that I am presenting for you. Please check the description and don't forget to share and subscribe. Okay, my friends, now coming to what are those important five concepts under the corresponding problems of indefinite integration. Now coming to concept number one. Suppose, this is one of the title favorite concept for advanced as well as JEE Mains aspirants. For several times questions were asked and repeated, especially under this concept. Actually, if your integrand is in the formula x square plus a square by x power 4 plus kx square plus a power 4, this is one stage. Or x square minus a square, that's why two integrands are there. In a single step, I have given that as what, x square plus or minus a square. So you just consider either plus or with minus. So two integrands you will identify. But denominator is similar, same for all. That is x power 4 plus kx square plus a power 4. Whenever this kind of problem is given for you, then what to do? The step one is you divide both numerator, nr means numerator and dr means denominator, both by x square. And if it is a plus, if numerator contains plus, you consider x minus a square by x is equal to t. And if numerator is minus, you consider x plus a square by x as a t. Then automatically that unknown integrand converted into known integrand. Suppose this is the question given for you. Integration x square plus 1 by x power 4 plus x square plus 1 dx. The same question even they asked in the JEE Main, one of the JEE Main or advanced straight objective questions. Sometimes they are lifting the questions from JEE advanced examination as it is, and they are giving those questions in the JEE Mains examination also. That's why if you are after completion of your preparation, my suggestion would be you just practice all 40 years of JEE, IIT JEE, old IIT JEE papers or JEE advanced new papers. Especially the straight objective questions, simple straight objective questions only. Don't go for complicated questions. Because if it is a simple straight objective question, the direct question should come in JEE Main examination also. Several times it was happened, even in 2020, January and September sessions, as I have observed several times. Clear, my friends? So that's why. Now, if it is the case, so as per the steps, what to do? You have to divide both numerator and denominator with x square. Then automatically it becomes what? 1 by 1 plus x square by x square plus 1 plus 1 by x square dx. So as per the solution, I am taking, because the numerator is a plus, so I am taking x minus a square means 1 by x is equal to t. This I am considering this as t. Why? Because if I have considered this as t, after differentiation it becomes 1 by 1 plus x square dx, that is equal to dt. That is why if numerator contains plus, I am taking x minus a square by x as t, or if numerator is with plus sign, minus sign, I take x plus a square by x as t. So what is there? Now automatically numerator is dt, it becomes, and I can write, of course, x minus, this denominator I can write x minus 1 by x whole square. This I can write it as x minus 1 by x whole square plus 3, if I am right. See, after expansion, what will happen? X minus x square plus 1 by x square minus 2. Minus 2 plus 3 is 1. So directly I can write this as what? Integration dt by t square plus 3. This is in the form of 1 by x square plus a square. What is 1 by x square plus a square? 1 by a tan inverse x by a. Apply this formula. So 1 by root 3 tan inverse x by root 3. T by root 3. What is t? My t is x minus 1 by x. You replace that. You can get the answer. So this model, problems based on this model are very, very useful. And of course, concept number 2. Suppose if integrand is like this. What I said, convert known integrand into the unknown, sir, unknown integrand into the known. So this is a unknown integrand. How to convert this unknown into known? See the link about the methodology, try to understand. So far I have in my hand concept number 1. So what I'm now doing is I'm just converting this unknown integrand into the previous concept 1. That means, can I write like this, the numerator? With conveniently I'm writing like this, x square minus a square plus x square plus a square, if I have written like this, or minus of like this, x power 4 plus kx square plus a power 4, then and conveniently getting the original this one, minus x square gets cancelled, and it is what, or I do like this, x square plus a square, x square plus a square minus of x square minus a square. I am writing like this. Minus of x square minus a square. Then I can balance with 1 by 2 a square. What will happen? X square gets cancelled, and 2 a square will come in the numerator, and again 2 a square gets cancelled. Again, what will get? I will get the same. After separation of this becomes what? 1 by 2 a square. X square plus a square by x power 4 plus kx square plus a power 4 minus of x square minus a square by x power 4 plus kx square plus a power 4. These are the familiar models. Familiar. They are concept number 1. They comes under concept number 1. And what to do according to the concept number 1? Divide both numerator and denominator with x square and put x plus or minus or plus a by x 1. A by x square as a t, you can get the answer very easily. Clear? So this is the method. The same thing here I am explaining in the form of methods and steps. Various 2 steps here I am providing it for you. Very easy steps there. So see, this I am giving like this. Okay. So that 1 by x power 4 plus kx square plus a power 4, I can write it as 1 by ax. Like, just try to understand. This is called the technique. This is called the concept, how to convert the unknown into known, that's all. So if I have converted this into the known, then the fact is automatically under with the help of concept number 1, you can solve the problem very quickly. So please note down this formula, and several times questions were repeated. Suppose if this is the question, dx by x power 4 plus suppose 60. If it is the question, then immediately what to do? If I am in your place, then I can do like this. This I can write it as x square minus 4. X square minus 16 minus x square plus 16 minus of x square minus 16 by x power 4 plus 16 I can write, and I am balancing this with by 32. So this can be 1 by 32. Integration x square plus 16 by x power 4 plus 16 dx minus x square minus 16 by x power 4 plus 16 dx. Then automatically what to do? Divide numerator with denominator with what? X square then put the corresponding x plus a by x or x minus a by x conveniently as your substitution, then automatically that will be in the form of 1 by a square minus x square or 1 by a square plus x square or 1 by x square minus a square or 1 by x square plus a square form. Then you know the very well all the standard results of 1 by a square minus x square, 1 by a square plus x square formulae. You apply them, you can get the answer directly. That's why this manipulation is very, very important. Clear? This is about concept number 2. Questions should come either in mains or advanced examination. This is one of the most important integrand. Now coming to concept number 3. See the difference between concept number 1, concept number 2, concept number 3. Now in my hand, concept number 1 is there and concept number 2 already we practiced with kind of manipulations. Similarly, here also what I am doing is, again I am applying the same manipulations for solving this one. What kind of manipulation that I am doing, here I am explaining in the form of a method. See? So what I am doing is, I have written the numerator like this. X square minus a square, x square plus a square minus of x square plus x square minus a square. So what will happen? X square gets cancelled and this becomes 2a square. Of course, here better is better, you take this plus, not minus plus. So automatically the 2x square comes in the numerator and divide with 2, then automatically the structure is the same. So then what to do? Separate them. Automatically again it comes under concept number 1. Apply concept number 1. So these are all are the developments. These are all are the consequences of concept number 1. So in general, than asking directly from concept number 1, they may create the questions in this format. Suppose if it is a case, suppose they have given question like this, x square by x power 4 plus x square plus 1. Suppose it is the question given for you. Then what to do? You just write numerator as x square plus 1 minus plus x square minus 1 by x power 4 plus x square plus 1 dx. Separate it and balance this. Balance with what? 1 by 2. So after separation, 1 by 2 integration, x square plus 1 by x power 4 plus x square plus 1 dx plus half into integration, x square minus 1 by x power 4 plus x square plus 1 dx. Then what to do? Divide both numerator and denominator with x square and put for first one as x minus 1 by x as t, for second one as x plus 1 by x as t. Automatically they can convert it into either 1 of 1 by a square minus x square or 1 by a square plus x square or 1 by a square minus x square format. You can apply the formula, you can get the answer directly. This conversion is the only part, but this is not the entire integration. This is just algebraic stuff. That's why the only final step is writing the final result only there. Integration takes place. Until that, we are just solving, applying the algebra. Clear, my friends? This is about concept number 3. So, in concept number 3 also, manipulation takes place. So, in integrations, they are asking the manipulation problems. Please practice this one. This is one of the best important example for the rational integration questions. Now, coming to concept number 4. Actually, of course, my friends, if I have multiplied this with two factors, if I have multiplied this, may get, we can quadratic. And you know what is quadratic and how to write the formula for 1 by x square plus b plus c, that I have explained in a series number 2 also. But here we can do partial fractions. Actually, in partial fractions we can apply substitute everywhere but not there model. Substitute everywhere but not there. This is another important shortcut concept whenever two different linear factors are given it for you. Suppose 1 by x plus 2 into 1 by x plus 2 into x plus 3 is given. So what to do? What is the concept? Substitute everywhere but not there. What is the meaning of that concept? That means x plus 2 becomes 0 when x is equal to minus 2. So substitute everywhere in the place of x with minus 2 except at x plus 2. Similarly, x plus 3 becomes 0 when x is equal to minus 3. Substitute x is equal to minus 3 everywhere other than at x plus 3. So what will happen? If I have substituted minus 2 everywhere, that means 1 by x plus 2 into minus 2 plus 3 plus, and x plus 3 becomes 0 when x is equal to minus 3. So 1 by minus 3 plus 2 into x plus 3. So it becomes what? 1 by x plus 2 minus 1 by x plus 3. This is the partial fraction, resolving into the partial fraction. This technique is called what? Substitute everywhere, but not there. Then, if you want integration of this problem, then what to do? Separate integration. And it is in 1 of 1 by x plus b. What is integration of 1 by x plus b? Log mod 1 by a log mod ax plus b plus c. So you can apply the formula. That means, so far it is unknown. I have converted this into the known. Then, done. Otherwise, you can product these two. You can get a quadratic equation, or directly you apply our series number 2. You just watch our previous videos. There I have given the direct shortcut formula for 1 by x square plus bx plus c. Apply that. But my friends, of course, here what I am doing is, suppose if it is given directly without writing conversion or everything, directly you can write answer like this. 1 by ad minus bc log mod ax plus b by cx plus t. That's all. That is the super shortcut. Shortcut ka bap hai ye. Suppose if I have given question like this, 1 by x plus 2 into x plus 3 integration. Suppose, then what could be the answer? 1 by ad minus bc, that means coefficient of x into constant of that term, and 1 by ad minus bc, these two terms, extremes and internals. So 1 by ad minus bc means 1 into 3, 3 minus 2 log mod first x plus 2 by x plus 3 plus 3. Khatam. So log mod x plus 2 by x plus 3. See how quickly I have solved this problem. But my friends, please don't forget, log x power k is equal to k log x. Log x power minus 1 is equal to minus 1 log x. Please don't forget the all basic properties of logarithms. That is logarithm manipulation. So read the all options very carefully and select the appropriate one. Have enjoyed it? It's a very simple one. Now coming to concept number 5. The same thing if I am given. Suppose this is the case. Again, I can do the manipulations. See, I can write the numerator like this. Suppose integration I have to find. So I can write like this, 1 by x square plus a square minus of x square minus b square by x square plus a square into x square plus b square. So I am balancing the numerator with 1 by 2 a square. Got it? Because x square gets cancelled. Sorry, 1 by 2 into a square minus b square. A square not minus b square, a square plus b square I can. So because x square gets cancelled, so in numerator you will get a square plus b square. So I have divided denominator with 2 into a square plus b square. So I can get 2 is not also necessary. That's all. After separation, you can get 1 by a square plus b square integration of 1 by x square plus b square minus integration of 1 by x square plus a square. And these two are the two familiar formula. 1 by x square plus a square is 1 by a tan inverse x square. You apply that. But even then, you can save the time with the help of this formula. You can also save the time just with the help of this formula. Suppose the question is given like this for you. Integration dx by, suppose if I am asking the question like this, integration dx by x square plus 3 into x square plus 4. So here my, whatever it may be, a is equal to 3, root 3 and b equal to 2. A equal to root 3 and b equal to 2. So my answer would be 1 by b square minus a square. 1 by b square minus a square means 4 minus 3. 1 by a, 1 by root 3, tan inverse x by root 3, minus 1 by b, that is 1 by 2, tan inverse x by 2. Directly I can write the answer. Or sometimes you may get a negative sign in the before the bracket, and you send it to, you put the negative sign into multiply with the terms, you can get the answer correspondingly. So my friends, these are the most powerful tips. Just with the 3 videos, what concepts that I have covered, total 15 concepts I have covered. Under these 15 concepts only several times questions were repeated, even they may give, even coming examination also. hope you enjoyed this one. And you please, if you like this video, you please share and subscribe. Already I mentioned, along this video, I am providing one grand test. And in that grand test, you should get physics and chemistry question paper also, just on par with the present standards and the models of JEE mains examination. Thank you, and we will meet with another video soon. Wish you all the best. See, this is all season 2 concepts. Okay, my friends? Thank you once again.